Yo, what's poppin', squad fam? It's your boy Scrubby here, back again with another video. Hope you guys are having a fantastic day. I know I am. I think I actually broke the flu's curse last night, so I'm feeling pretty great. And if you guys are feeling great too, then do me a favor and press the like button. And if you don't press the like button, no joke, no scam, you will actually get the flu. Yeah, that's right. I got rid of it, but I still have a little bit of it. And if you don't press the like button, it might terminate ya. I don't make the rules, man. I just follow them. Real talk though, guys, I hope you are having a great day. As you can tell from today's title and thumbnail, I have quite the story for you guys involving absolutely 1v1 owning a bully. Every now and then, you just gotta do the take the L dance on whoever's picking on you and then remind them that their mother is a promiscuous woman that you have enjoyed many a night with. So, I personally never really got bullied that much in school. I'm just not really a person that's easy to bully. Bullies want an easy target, and I'm kind of known for running my mouth and being able to talk trash really well. Like, I'm a really good trash talker, okay? The other day in Rainbow Six Siege, I made 4 people on the other team leave just by typing in game chat. Like, I'm not a bully's favorite target because I'm pretty tall, you know, I'm not afraid to fight even though I'm not very good at it, and I like to talk trash, so bullying me isn't exactly the easiest thing in the universe. So I was very fortunate. I never really had a ton of people picking on me, and when people would try, it didn't really bug me that much. But sadly, not everyone in my family is that way. I have this cousin who, bless his heart, is kind of a target for bullying. He's a weird kid. He's into some weird stuff. Not that I think it's weird, but it's stuff that, like, normal people think is weird, you know? He's really into Magic the Gathering. He's really good at it, too. He tried to teach me how to play once and just destroyed me. He's not a super athletic kid. He's kind of dorky. And I guess a lot of people at his school bully him a ton. And I only know this because when I saw him at Christmas, he was like, "Yo, Ryan, did you ever get bullied in school?" And I was like, "Nah, not really, man." And he's like, "Yeah, I get picked on a lot. Do you have any advice for how to deal with it?" And I don't know why he asked me for advice, alright, because my life isn't exactly, like, you know, in the perfect spot that I've ever been. Like, my life, you know, it's good. I'm not gonna complain or anything, but I don't really have my crap together incredibly well. I'm sitting here talking to a microphone by myself at, like, 9 in the morning. Anyways, I saw him at Christmas, and I asked him to tell me what's up, and basically, there's these kids in PE that are always picking on him. They're basically always like, "Oh, dude, you're so stupid, you're so ugly, like, why did you even take PE, you fat kid?" Like, they're really mean, alright? He's telling me stuff that they're telling him, and I'm like, "Oh, okay, so this isn't, you know, haha, you're bad at math." Like, these kids are coming up to him at lunch and causing problems with them. He's like, "I don't know what to do." And here's the thing about my cousin, you know, we have some of the same genes, we have the same, paternal side. It's my dad's brother's kid, so, like, we have the same dad's side, and, he's about as tall as me. I'm 6'3", so my cousin's 6'3", and he weighs about 2 of me, all right? He's a big dude. He's a big dude. I'm 6'3", like 190, so, okay, maybe not half of me, but he's probably like 300 pounds. He's a big dude, 6'3", 300 pounds. So he's telling me all this, and I'm like, "Dog, listen, I'm not trying to be that dude, but you're gigantic. Why don't you just, like, rip them in half with your bare hands, dude? Like, you're a giant. You are a big dude." And he starts telling me about how he doesn't want to fight, he doesn't want to hurt anyone, and, like, you know, yeah, they're messing with him, but they're not actually causing any harm. They're just calling him names and, like, messing with their games of Magic when they're playing at lunch, all that stuff. And I'm like, "Look, man, personally, me just being honest here, I'm not somebody that, like, lets myself really get picked on. I'm always the person who's, you know, running my mouth or trying to fight somebody if they do me wrong, so that's what I would do if I were you. I think you need to stand up for yourself. The fact that you're not standing up for yourself is why they keep picking on you." And he's like, "Yeah, Ryan, I think you're right, man, you know, maybe I will stand up for myself." And after that, I was like, "Man, I helped out my cousin, look at that. I'm solving problems out here. Somebody get me the Nobel Peace Prize, because I'm out here just changing lives. Oh my lord." And I hadn't seen my cousin since, all right? No big deal, no harm, no foul. And then a couple days ago, I'm chilling and I get a phone call and I see that it's my uncle. And I don't talk to my uncle much on the phone. I don't really do a ton of boomer speak, you know? Like, it's not every day that my uncle that I don't see that often calls me and starts talking to me. So obviously I pick up the phone and the first thing out of his mouth is, "Why did you tell my son to get in a fight?" And I go, "Huh? What are you talking about?" And he's like, "My son is currently in the dean's office getting suspended because he fought some kids." And I'm like, okay. And he says, "And he told me that you told him to do it." And I'm like, whoa, I didn't tell him to do it. So I explained to him the entire situation. I'm like, "Look, he told me he's getting bullied. He asked me what I would do. I said I'd stand up to him. And the reason I'd stand up to them is because, you know, personally, I'm not the type of guy that really likes to let myself get picked on." And I explained to him why the bullies are messing with him. And he's like, "Oh, okay, so you didn't tell him to just walk up to these kids and punch him in the face. You said if they keep messing with you, stand up for yourself." I go, "Yeah." He's like, "All right, well, you know, all I heard is that you told him to get in a fight. I'm going to go to the school now and figure out what happened. I'm like, all right, so keep me updated. About an hour later, I get another call from my uncle, except this time it's a FaceTime, and I answer, and my cousin is sitting there with this gigantic smile on his face. So I ask him what's going on, and he says, you're not in trouble, my dad's not mad. Here's what went down. So I guess he was in the PE locker room, and the bullies had kind of left him alone since they got back from Christmas break, but after a week or two of being back, they had finally gotten up the courage to mess with the big kid again. So he's sitting there in PE, and basically, the bullies come up to him and they start messing with him, and he's just ignoring them. He's like, I was literally ignoring them. I wasn't doing anything. And ignoring them just makes the bullies angrier, right? Like, they really, really wanted a reaction. That's what they thrive off of. That's what they desperately crave is a reaction. So they started increasing the intensity of what they were calling him. They went from like, you're fat, get out of PE. And they were like, oh, you're stupid. You're never going to amount to anything. They start calling him, other words that I can't really say because I want this video to stay monetized, you know? And I guess one of the bullies was like a teacher's aides for my cousin's English class, and they had just had a project where they had to write an essay about something that was really hard for them to overcome. And my cousin's grandma on his mom's side, so not my grandma, but like his mom's mom, has cancer, and she's okay now, but for a while, like, things didn't look good. So he wrote his essay about how hard it was to watch his grandma struggle with chemo and going through all that, and like, it was hard on his family, you know. And it was supposed to be a private essay. He didn't really think any students were going to watch it, but for whatever reason, the teacher decided to have her student aides grade these essays, and the kid happened to be an aide. So he had read this kid's essay about, or my cousin's essay about how his grandma had cancer, and he's ignoring them still, even after they increased the insults. And the kid, to get a reaction, goes, well, whatever, I hope your grandma's cancer comes back, which is the worst thing to say. Like, the fact that human beings can say that to each other and not spontaneously just explode blows mine. How could you look at another human being and say, I hope your grandma's cancer comes back? If you are able to say that, I honestly think for the good of humanity, we should just catapult them into the sun. Let's buy a gigantic catapult. A huge one. I'm talking the world's biggest catapult, and we're just gonna start launching it at anybody that is able to say the words, I hope your grandma's cancer comes back. We're launching them to the sun, no harm, no foul. It's not like anything on the planet is gonna miss them anyways. Obviously, though, this gets them the reaction that they want, and my cousin, 6'3", you know, 300 pound, decides, I've had enough. And these kids that are like 5'5 and 5'6", you know, you're gonna make fun of me, whatever. You're gonna call me fat, whatever. You're gonna call my hobbies weird, whatever. I can handle that. But if you're gonna tell me that my grandma deserves to get cancer, nah, bruh. Now we got some beef. So I guess what he decides to do is very classily, very, very classily, pick up the ringleader and throw him into the lockers in the PE locker room. Like, throw him into them. So he gets tossed into the locker and like falls to the ground, and his friends are like, yeah, and like start trying to punch my cousin. The only problem is, like I said, these kids are tiny, so they're trying to punch him, and my cousin is pissed. He's seeing red, because when you say that somebody's grandma deserves to get cancer, they tend to get a little bit angry with you. They don't tend to take that very well. I know. Who would have thunk that making fun of somebody's grandma's getting cancer is a good way to get beat up? And at this point, you know, they're all kind of not a problem, but he decides that that's not enough. He's like, nah, you gotta make fun of my grandma's cancer, then you get tossed. So he goes over to the kid that he tossed in the locker the first time, the ringleader who said it, and just, you know, keeps roughing him up on the ground a little bit, just keeps, you know, I would never advocate for violence here on this YouTube channel, ever in my life, no. Susan, if you're watching this, don't fight people, kids. Don't do it, all right? I'm not trying to get in trouble. So he's wailing on this kid angry, as he is when somebody makes fun of your grandma getting cancer. And it takes both of the PE coaches to peel him off of the kid. I guess one PE coach was trying to pull him off, and my cousin started kicking. And obviously, they get him separated. They send him to the dean's office, and the three kids won't even look my cousin in the eye. They're all sobbing, crying about how he hit us. So they get to the dean's office, and at first, the dean is mad at my cousin because these kids are sitting here crying, obviously in some pretty rough shape. So my cousin starts explaining to them what happened, and they're like, all right, well, call your dad. We need your parents to come in. So all of the parents get together in the conference room, the parents of the kids who got, you know, smacked, and my uncle, and they start talking about what happened. So my cousin starts saying, well, your kids were making fun of the fact that my grandma had cancer and all this stuff, and the parents are like, did you do that? And he's like, well, yeah, but it was just to get a reaction because he wasn't responding. And so the parents are mad at their kids for making fun of this. And then the dean says, but I do believe that you owe them an apology for going too far. Violence is never the answer at the school. We want to raise people that solve problems in an adult way. So you do owe them an apology. And my cousin's like, I'm not going to apologize. And they're like, well, you need to apologize. And my uncle's like, you want him to apologize for beating them up after they made fun of his grandma having cancer. And he's like, well, yeah, he needs to learn that to solve problems in the adult world, violence isn't always the answer. And even the parents of the kids who got beat up are kind of like, I don't know about that one, Chief. Like, if you kind of make fun of someone's grandma getting beat up then or getting cancer, then you kind of deserve it. And the dean is like, well, if you don't apologize, then there needs to be a punishment. You're going to be suspended for 3 days for fighting. So just apologize and get it over with. My cousin's like, I'm not apologizing. And so the dean is like, well, then I guess you're going to be suspended for 3 days. And my cousin says, all right, I guess I'm suspended for 3 days. And his dad says, all right, I guess we'll be back in 3 days. And they get up and go to leave. And the dean is like, wow, you're gonna let your child get suspended instead of apologizing? And my uncle just goes off on the dean and is like, the fact that you have the balls to ask my son to apologize after what these kids says shows that you're like a spineless coward. I'll take the suspension. My son will be back when his suspension is over. And they leave. And they get in the car. He says, FaceTime your cousin, because I'm pretty sure he thinks that I'm mad at him. And they FaceTime me and told me everything. Moral of the story is, don't make fun of people's grandmas getting cancer and you probably won't get beat up. So, yeah, my cousin's gonna have a nice 3-day vacation. He went and got some food after that, rousing workout that he got. My uncle went, took him, got a milkshake, all that good stuff. And, I highly, highly doubt that those bullies will be picking on him anymore when he goes back to school. Anyways, guys, that's gonna do it for the video. Hopefully you enjoyed. If you did, be sure to press the like button, comment down below, and turn on those notifications. Today's notification shout-out goes to the very cool Ewan Stewart. Big thank you for having on notifications. Turn on notifications for notification shout-out. Send a screenshot to my Instagram, @scrubby. And, yeah, don't get anyone pregnant if you do, make sure they're hot. Cop the merch, and I'll see you guys tomorrow with another video. I'm out. Peace.